Good morning and welcome to Math Class. And I'm sorry I'm not here today, but something is keeping me away from class, but we are still going to go ahead and do something. And Ms. Lewis is in class to help you if you need any help. Our objective for today is to be able to subtract fractions. So we all know what fractions are, and just to kind of jar your memory in case you haven't forgotten, the numerator is the top number and the denominator is the bottom number. So we're going to look at some examples, but before I do that, let me explain what you're going to be responsible for today. After I go over these examples, you'll do your warm-up. And after your warm-up, Ms. Lewis will go over the answers with you, and then you can do your classwork and your exit slip, and you'll be done for today. There is a Moby Mac lesson that I'm going to add that you'll be able to do if you do get finished early. But make sure you do a good job, and remember that when I'm not in class, everything that you do counts as a product grade. So your warm-up, your classwork, and your exit slip all put together will be one big product grade, and remember that your product grades count more than your process grades. So now let's look at subtracting some fractions. Okay, so let's practice some subtraction of fractions. And let's start with something very, very easy. If you remember from addition of fractions, when the denominators are the same, all you have to do is add the numerators. So if we're subtracting and the denominators are the same, what do you think you have to do to the numerators? Of course, you have to subtract. So let's subtract 7 from 3, and we are going to get 4, and the numerator stays 12. Am I finished with this problem, though? Okay, some of you said no, and you're certainly correct. What do I have to do to this problem in order to finish it? Okay, I need to simplify this fraction. And remember that the way that we simplify is we look for a number that divides both into the numerator and into the denominator. So what number will go into both 4 and 12? Great, 4. And 4 goes into 4 one time, and 4 goes into 12 three times, so our answer is 1/3. Okay, we're going to look at another example, and this example is a little more difficult because we're subtracting 1/4 from 2/3. And remember that I could do this on a number line or I could do it pictorially, but we're going to do it using mathematical reasoning. So the first thing I've got to do is convert both 2/3 and 1/4 to some number that has the same denominator. So take a crack at what you think that denominator would be. Okay, I would use 12. And the easiest way to figure it out is 3 times 4 is 12, so I know that both numbers go into 12, so I can convert to 12ths. So to convert 2/3 to 12ths, I could multiply the 3 times 4 to get 12ths. So I have to do the same thing to the numerator that I do to the denominator, so I multiply the numerator times 4, and I get 8. So 2/3 is equal to 8/12ths. Then I'm going to subtract 1/4, and I need to do the same thing. I need to convert that into 12ths. So I know that 4 goes into 12 three times, so I have to multiply the 4 times 3 to get 12, so I have to multiply the 1 times 3, so I get 3/12ths. Now that I have my numerators the same, this becomes very, very simple because all I have to do is subtract my numerators. So 3 from 8 is 5, so my answer is 5/12ths. If you have any questions, Ms. Lewis can help you before we go on to the next one. Okay, let's look at our last example. 3/8 minus 3/16. Here, I'm not going to multiply 8 times 16 because that's a big number. And you all know I don't like big numbers real well. But I know that 8 goes into 16. So I know that I can convert 3/8 into 16ths. So that's what I'm going to do to solve this problem. So if I want to make 8 16ths, I have to multiply the denominator by what?
2.
Right, the correct answer is 2. So I'm going to convert this into 16ths by multiplying both the numerator and the denominator by 2. So I'm going to get 3 times 2 is 6, 8 times 2 is 16. So 3/8 is equal to 6/16. And then I'm going to subtract 3/16 from that, and I get 3/16. Are there any questions? Okay, Ms. Lewis will give you access to your warm-up and then your classwork and your exit slip. And remember that all three of them put together will be a product grade. And I hope you have a great rest of the day. Thank you.